We are continuing our Audioversity series on Rivage PM systems with a video about word clock setup and using additional interface cards. Previously, we've looked at how to use the twin lane and the Dante networks. Now we'll see how to link with other equipment and make sure everything is synchronized. Why is synchronization important? Well, imagine if a railway network didn't keep its station clocks and train clocks in sync. They might start off safely, but as the clocks drift out of time, some trains will be late, some will be early, and there will eventually be a crash. Such a crash in an audio network would either cause a nasty noise or deadly silence. We must avoid it. So, allow me to give you some tips. Firstly, in a Rivage system, a DSP engine must be the clock master. If you are using twin lane, then all RPIO units will be clock slaves. If there are multiple DSP engines in the system, select one as the master and set the others to slave status. Do this in the setup menu and the word clock page. Then for the master DSP engine, you would need to select the word clock source. If you wish to use the internal clock of the engine, just select the sample rate. 96 kHz is the default, and it's our recommendation for the best performance. If you need to use an external word clock source, perhaps to synchronize to a broadcasting house clock, then you must use the word clock in of the master DSP engine. If you have one or more Dante cards in the DSP engine, you'll see an additional word clock source option, the HY slot which hosts the Dante card. Before you select this, have a careful thought about the system. Can the Dante card in the DSP engine become the master Dante device without interfering with the rest of the network? This is easy to answer if you're the only engineer and just have a few RIO units and wireless mic receivers. So, if you can, keep the DSP running on its internal clock, and in the system config for the HY slot, set the HY144D Dante card to preferred master and sync to external. And remember, in this case, sync to external means the Dante card will sync to a clock outside of the Dante network. In this case, the clock of the DSP engine. Making these settings will ensure the HY144D card will become the Dante master. Just make sure there are no other Dante devices in the network that have sync to external enabled. On the other hand, if Rivage needs to join an existing Dante network that already has a defined clock strategy and a nominated master device, you will need to make the complete Rivage system slave to Dante's clock. That's actually very simple and easy. In the word clock setup, select from HY slot as the word clock source for the master DSP engine. Then select the required sampling frequency to be compatible with the other Dante devices. For the HY144D back in the Dante setup, make sure preferred master is off and sync to external is also off. Now, suppose some of your Dante equipment runs at 48 kHz, but you want the Rivage system to run at 96 kHz. Then you need the HY144D SRC card, which will sample rate convert for you. There are 5 different ways to set up that card, so let's save that for the next video. Alternatively, consider having 2 Dante networks. One for I/O devices connected to HY slot 3 and one for live recording and virtual sound check connected to HY slot 4. How should we handle that? Obviously, RIVAGE cannot sync to two different sources at the same time, so just one master clock is required for everything. That should either be the DSP engine or a Dante device in one of the networks. In either case, one Dante network must be a slave to the DSP engine. The DSP engine can act as a clock transfer between both Dante networks. So, I think it's easier to make the recording network slave to the DSP engine. In that case, the Dante card in slot 4 must be set to sync to external, so it syncs to the clock from its host device. And preferred master must be on, so it's most likely to become the Dante master device. Then the recording device must be a Dante slave. Now let's think about MADI, because the HY128MD is an option for live recording systems, or sharing audio with other mixing systems. This card provides up to 128 channels in and out at 48 kHz through two MADI connections. It will manage 64 channels in and out at 96 kHz. And it includes sample rate converters, so you can record at 48 kHz even if you mix at 96 kHz. Do be mindful that RIVAGE cannot sync to the incoming clock from MADI, so the SRCs could be useful even if the sample rate is the same. The HY128MD does have some flexible options. Firstly, it has two redundant modes with different input priorities. So the coaxial connectors can be a backup for the optical, or the other way round. Or mode 2 allows optical 2 to back up optical 1, and coax 2 will back up coax 1. There's also a split option where the inputs are sent out again. So it's best not to use that for live recording. It's more useful if you need to receive inputs from a MADI device and then forward them to a second destination. Then, here you have the usual MADI frame rate and channel format settings, which you need to select to match the connected device. Now let's consider the options for using a HY card in slot 2 of an RPIO unit. This can be useful if you need Dante or MADI equipment on stage or in a remote place. The RPIO unit allows a choice of routing modes. So, open the setup menu, system config, choose HY slot 1 or 2, which has the twin lane ring. Then touch the RPIO unit. And above the HY slot, you will see the routing mode. Mode 1 will split the inputs, so all 128 possible inputs from the front panel will be routed out of the HY2 slot. So that could be all 96 inputs from the RY cards and an additional 32 inputs from the MY cards. This is useful if you want to share the inputs with another mixing console via MADI or Dante. But note, there's no analog gain control possibility for the other console, though there is a gain compensation facility in the RPIO. The other engineer will have to rely on their own digital gain adjustments. The alternative routing mode 2 allows any outputs to be freely patched from the twin lane ring to the Dante or MADI card. Both modes allow free patching from the HY2 card into twin lane to accept MADI or Dante inputs. Just be aware that the RIVAGE system has no control of any Dante devices that are connected to just this card. Control is only possible for the devices networked with the Dante HY cards in the DSP engine. And remember, it's the same condition for the smaller MY cards. There are no remote control possibilities and no external clocking possibilities with the MY cards. Rivage wants to be your master. We've covered a lot of details today. In the next video, we're going to check all the possibilities for the HY144D SRC card. How to deal with Dante at different sample rates. It's more flexible than me. See you again soon.